Opening weekend, Keeneland 2024, and that means it's time for the Keeneland Breeders' Futurity. It is a win-and-you're-in race for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile, and it does offer points on the Kentucky Derby Trail. They're going to be going a mile and a 16th. It's two-year-old colts at Keeneland, and we've got some precocious runners. It is a grade one, and the Kentucky Derby prep season continues. Race number five. This week, we've got the Champagne, the Keeneland Futurity, and the American Pharoah Stakes from Santa Anita. 10 points to the winner, 5 points for second, and points awarded all the way down to fifth place. It did draw a field of 11 horses, led by a Saratoga shipper, Ferocious. He picked up a win in his debut, was second in his last race in the Hopeful Stakes. He is ridden by Louis Saez. Saratoga Cruiser enters out of post position number two. Meanwhile, Optical drew off to a big victory last time out at Churchill Downs. Big 12-length win. He gets James Grange. Handsome Pants won first time out, and he did it at Churchill Downs. He goes for trainer Ken McPeak and Brian Hernandez. East Avenue for Godolphin Blue, a winner, first time out of the box. That was at Ellis Park. He stays right here in Kentucky at Keeneland. Meanwhile, Feloso out of post position number six. He ships in from New York. He picked up a win. John Velasquez rides Feloso. Mesoro sent out by trainer Dale Romans. He ran evenly in the Iroquois. He came off the pace in his debut win. Big Boat enters out of post position number eight. Tenacious Leader is another one for Todd Pletcher. Enters here with a chance to pick up some black type. Dapper Moon, post position 10, and on the outside is Ready for Peace, number 11, and that rounds out the field with Jose Ortiz. A solid field of 11. We've got some Saratoga shippers. We've got winners from Ellis. We've got some Churchill Downs winners, and the field has been drawn. Post position, wearing the red silks out of rope, post position number one for Ferocious. Optical number three, Big Boat, Dapper Moon, and Ready for Peace, other contenders. Let's take a look at this race. We'll watch the video replays, find out how they got here. Take a look at some of these fast maiden winners, including Ferocious. Let's go back to his maiden win. Highly touted off some fast workouts, Ferocious did not disappoint. Broke a step slow, was inside on a little bit of a sloppy track, came motoring down the lane. Ferocious picked up that win from off the pace after a slow start. Then we go to the Hopeful Stakes. Ferocious bet down to the favorite, fast speed figure in his debut. He goes wide for the drive, kind of struggled early to get going. Then he kind of kicked it in with Chancer McPatrick. He's inside Chancer McPatrick. He ends up running second in this stakes race. Ferocious, one of the favorites in the Keeneland Futurity. Handsome Pants for trainer Ken McPeak. Let's go back to Churchill Downs. This was a highly competitive maiden race. Another horse, Kinetic Sky, was bet down, but Handsome Pants took advantage of the rail trip, saved ground with Brian Hernandez, and kicked away clear late in this race. Handsome Pants, one to be reckoned with here in the Keeneland Futurity. Feloso, a dominating win in his last start. That was at Saratoga, a maiden race. Look at him come into the stretch and then just bounds clear late. Kind of picked up the pace late in that race. Nice buyer speed figure. And Feloso won with a chance to improve here in his third lifetime start. Now we go to Godolphin Blue, East Avenue. We go back to the Pea Patch, Ellis Park. East Avenue getting all the money, 6-5 in his debut. Did not disappoint. He's bounding down the lane, kind of in hand. The jockey wraps him up late. We don't know what kind of talent he has. He's lightly raced, but those Ellis Park maiden races are tough. And he won his debut race for Godolphin Blue. Mesoro, Dale Roman sends him out, start number three. He was a closer in his debut, ran evenly in the Iroquois, stretches out here to a mile and a 16th for the Keeneland Futurity. Optical was 6-1 in his last race. He made that look like a laugher as he wins by 12 lengths. That was at Churchill Downs. Optical improving, and he gets the right running style for this race. I think the pace will be just a little bit above average. We've got some fast maiden winners, but they do have some distance pedigree. Optical, one to consider. Now let's take a look at the pace of the race, and this one gets a little bit tricky. An average pace, but remember, the Keeneland stretch is short. So once they come into that stretch, you want to be in that top three coming into the stretch. East Avenue, I'm going to put him on the lead, but maybe it could be Optical. Another one to consider is Ferocious. You know, he hasn't had the lead in his first two races. He may have more speed. It is his third lifetime start. He could be forwardly placed. You've got Optical and Handsome Pants coming from off the pace, most likely. But again, when they're lightly raced and they're coming from different surfaces and racetracks, it's kind of hard to get a gauge. I just know with that short stretch, you do need to be within a couple of lengths turning for home. Now, the big handicap in questions, a good race to handicap, an 11 horse field. Ferocious, he's got to ship in to Kentucky and go a mile to 16th. Handsome Pants, can he improve off that maiden effort? And he's a little bit further outside this time. Filoso dramatically improved the last race. He fits in here at this grade one level for the Keeneland Futurity. Now, overall, the form factors, we've got the fast maiden winners, East Avenue and Filoso. We got some mistakes experience with Ferocious and Mesoro. And it really can make the case for a couple of other nice maiden winners and Handsome Pants and some of the outside horses. That's where some of the speed may be congregated out in the middle of the track. My top selection in a wide open Keeneland Futurity, I'm going to go with East Avenue. I was impressed with that maiden win. I'm going to play him in exactas with Ferocious, Filoso, and Optical. Remember, you don't want to take too short of a price. A lot of these horses come in with big reputations. Definitely can make a case for Ferocious. He got going late in the hopeful. Mesoro ran evenly, I thought. Handsome Pants, definitely another contender. And Optical, if he continues to improve, he's right there just based off that last race that he won at 6-1. It is the Juvenile Showcase weekend for Future Stars Friday. The Champagne Stakes preview is already up, along with the Frisette. We've got the Keeneland Futurity and the Alcibiades will be Friday at Keeneland opening day, and the American Pharoah and the Oakleaf at Santa Anita, all part of a big weekend of juvenile racing for Kentucky Derby preps and also winning your in for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile. Champagne Stakes preview is already up. You can watch that. A nice field of 10. The Frisette Stakes drew a big field in New York, one turn mile, and Belmont at the Big A. And the Alcibiades Stakes will be Friday. We'll be getting that preview up soon. A nice field entered there. And free racing picks for Belmont, all the races, top three selections. Sign up below in the description. If you've already signed up, you're good to go. We're going to have Keeneland next week and racing picks every Saturday up until the Breeders' Cup. And it's free. Just sign up in the description. Ferocious, Optical, Handsome Pants, East Avenue, Big Boat, and Tenacious Leader. Any one of those definitely contenders can definitely win. I'm going with East Avenue. I'm going to play him in exactas over Filoso. I do think you want to take a look at Mesoro and Ferocious. Definitely top contenders in this race. Winning you're in for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile. And 10 points for the Kentucky Derby to the winner, 5 points for second. It's a big weekend of juvenile racing, and the Breeders' Futurity is part of it at Keeneland. Who do you like in the Keeneland Futurity? And remember, Dwayne Lucas always says people have opinions, horses have the facts.